Hi, and welcome to Lisa's Stamp Studio. My name is Lisa Curcio. Today is Wednesday, and it's October 13th. The year is 2021. This is a YouTube live streaming event. Whether you are joining me for the very first time or you are here back visiting my channel, I am so glad that you've joined me. Tonight, I'm going to teach you how to make a handmade Christmas buckle fun fold card. That's a mouthful. Now, if this is a fun fold you may have tried before, I've got a little spin on it for tonight that does not use a punch. And I've got tons of tips for you along the way. And the best part is I have six other cards to share with you tonight using the same bundle of products that I'm going to be sharing with you. They're going to be all part of my online card making class this month. Now, a couple things before we get started. You're not going to want to miss the free project sheet that I'm going to share with you. That's going to be available down in the video description below the title. It'll be there after the live stream is over. If you click on that, it'll navigate you over to all the pictures, the cutting dimensions, and the supplies that I've used for tonight's card. In addition to that, I would love to interact with you. So do me a favor and log into your YouTube account, which is your Gmail address. That's going to allow you to chat whether you're here during the live or perhaps you're watching the replay. I come back and I read every single comment. So your feedback is very important to me. And then before we get started, one last housekeeping item. I would love to introduce you to Gina Curcio Hawley. You might notice that surname. She is also a Curcio, which means she's my daughter. Gina has been stamping with me the entire 23 years I've been a demonstrator, and she is more than capable of being able to answer your questions and provide links. And you'll find her name here in blue. She's here moderating tonight because honestly, I can't keep up with all your comments while I'm trying to stamp. I think we're ready. Let's go ahead and let's get started. We're going to start with the paper trimmer, and I love this because it includes both the scoring and the cutting blades. The light is for scoring, the dark is for cutting. They navigate up and down out of the way. You can keep them on the clear track at the exact same time. This clear track is fantastic when you're doing small measurements and when you need precise cutting and scoring dimensions. Tonight's fun fold card is really, really easy. And I have a Christmas theme on mine, but I want you to keep in mind that you can use this fun fold for any occasion whatsoever. As I said in the introduction, make sure you hang with me. I've got six more cards to share with you. Now this card base looks a little smaller than what you might normally use, and this is 4 1/4 by 8 5/8. Please remember all the cutting and scoring dimensions are going to be in your free project sheet. You're going to do one score line, and that's going to be at 3 1/8 of an inch. I love it. There's a nice straight edge here at the top. There's also one at the bottom so you can keep your cardstock nice and straight, because if you're anything like me, you can't do anything straight. And then I'm going to use that scoring blade just to create that score line. So I'm going to set that aside for just a moment because we're going to do one more. This is a smaller piece of white cardstock. This measures 2 5/8 by 7. And we're going to score this one at the 3 1/2 inch mark, which is in essence in half. All right. That is all there is to this, okay? So let me set that trimmer off to the side. Let's come over here now to the actual card base. I'm a big fan of my bone folder for those nice crisp creases. So I'm gonna go over that with my bone folder. I want to make sure that this is gonna lay very, very nicely when I go ahead and I'm gonna do my rest of my stamping. Now the next step, if you're going to do this, is to add your designer series paper. That's gonna be very important before we create the opening for the mechanism of this fold. And I'm gonna go ahead and do that here. I'm gonna bring in my silicone craft sheet. I love this thing because adhesive liquid glue and hot glue will not stick to it, which means I'm gonna keep my work surface sticky free. All of the products you're gonna be able to find in my online store over at lisastampstudio.com. This comes from the Gingerbread and Peppermint Designer Series paper stack. It is an abundant stack of 6x6 papers, and I love that one side really is kind of themed and the other one is generic, and it's very reminiscent of all the Stampin' Up! Designer Series papers. Let's go ahead and let's add our adhesive here to the back side, and you're going to notice I'm going to be generous around the outside, and I'm going to also be generous around the center, and I'm going to explain why in just a second. Primarily here in the middle. Because I don't do too many things straight, I'm going to open this up, and here's another tip for you. I'm going to turn this horizontally. I have better luck of getting things even all the way around if I can see it horizontally versus vertically. I stand when I craft, you sit, maybe you stand. I just find this is easier for me. Then we're gonna go ahead and tack that down in place. Now I'm gonna move that silicone craft sheet for just a moment. And the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna have to create the opening that's going to hold the mechanism for this buckle. Now I'm gonna give you a little tip. Many years ago, this buckle fold was very, very popular using punches. And over the years, those punches have retired and become very, very difficult to use. And I decided to use a die. And I found one from the cloche die set that works famously. Let me just pull it in here for you. This little die right here was intended to be the bottom of the cloche, like a shaker dome. Now, you're gonna see me use this in some of the other cards because I have fallen in love with this die set. Now, this does not necessarily coordinate entirely with the stamps I'm gonna use, but I'm gonna give you a great tip about mixing and matching your dies and your stamps, so hang with me for that. This is actually going to get centered in this panel. And again, you're gonna see that I turned this horizontally to make it easier for my hand. I'm gonna lay that die right about where I think it needs to go. And if you're like me, it's gonna be moving all over the place, especially when you go to bring in your clear cutting mat. So what I like to do is I like to get everything ready before I take it over to my die cutting machine. Now this product is not in my online store because it's not a Stampin' Up! Product. This is the post-it note labeling and cover-up tape. And this is under my craft room favorites on my website. Comes in a dispenser, you're only gonna need a little bit, and you can reuse this over and over and over again. I actually rip it in half so that it's not even as wide. Now my craft room favorites can be found on my website under the shop tab near the bottom, and there's lots of fun things there for you that aid me here in my crafting here in the studio. They're not necessarily Stampin' Up! Products in my online store. So what I wanna do is I'm looking just visually. Now a lot of you like to measure, go for it. I don't like to measure. I'm a visual person. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna line this up. I'm looking here and here to see if it's evening. I'm looking here and here. And that post-it tape is going to anchor that die down in position. And then all you have to do is run this through your die cutting machine with your other plate on the top. Now, just in order to keep things a little bit more moving along, I did do that ahead of time. So let me pull that one out and let me bring this one in. So all I did was I simply peeled off the die from this once it was die cut. And I want to give you a little tip about this. I went ahead and I saved this paper and I put it right here on top of my little dispenser, or you can actually attach it to your die cutting machine that's going to have it handy for you every time you want to use it. Fantastic. Now we've got the hole that we need, but let's go ahead and let's work on this card so the pieces are going to come together. Next, I have another piece of designer series paper, and I know it kind of looks strange, but hang with me because there's a mechanism that's going to go here. And then what I'm going to do is show you again, that's that double-sided designer series paper that is also from the gingerbread and peppermint. Let's go ahead and add adhesive now to what's going to be the wrong side of my designer series paper. I'm using the Stampin' Seal Plus. It is super duper strong. One of my very worst things that I do is press too hard. That dispenser doesn't need a whole lot of pressure. And then we're just going to go ahead and center this here. I'm looking to leave that margin all the way around, and then we'll press that in place. Now the secret really is the piece that goes here. So let's go ahead and let's set that off to the side and let's go back to this piece of cardstock. This was the one that we scored in half, and I'm gonna go over that with my bone folder. Now I'm going to start by telling you that intuitively you're gonna wanna go this way with the crease on the left. That's not what we're gonna do. We're gonna work with it with the crease on the right. But I'm gonna shove that off to the side for just a second because now we're gonna do our stamping. I've got another piece of white cardstock here and I'm going to be using the images from Sweets and Treats. I have fallen in love with this, and wait until you see my other six cards. You're gonna see why. It's gonna make great birthday cards as well. I don't know about you, but I have friends that, you know, have been struggling with the flu already this year, and this would make a great get well card as well. Again, wait till I show you some other cards. So these images obviously can be colored in. You can use any coloring medium that you want, but I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use my Stampin' Blends. Now, I'm not gonna color them all for you. I have them done, but I do wanna walk you through a couple things about the stamp set. Now, the first thing is this adorable fruitcake, and this is obviously for Christmas because it has holly on the top. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna ink that up. You're gonna see how I'm moving that stamp across that ink pad to make sure that I don't miss a spot. The great thing about photopolymer is that your stamp is going to turn the color of the ink, which is going to make it really easy for you to see if you've missed a spot. Now here comes that pie, and I'm going to stamp that here, and they're going to all be separate on here. That's going to make it easy. And then there's that candy apple. I'm a candy apple lover. Anybody else? And we're going to stamp that here. All right, that's it. Those are the images I decided to do, and I'm going to show you how I put them together in just a moment. Now, just because I don't want to color the whole thing while you're watching, I did want to give you a coloring tip or two. As I mentioned, I love the Stampin' Blends alcohol-based markers. There's a light and a dark shade of every color, and they come in the combination $9 US price. These are fantastic. You're gonna see here by the line that there's a thicker tip and there's a thinner tip. Depending on what you're coloring in is going to help you to determine what size tip is gonna be best for your project. I'm gonna start with my lightest shade first. That is just a Lisa preference. You're gonna experiment to see what you like best. I'm gonna work right down here on my candy apple. Because that's a small area, I'm gonna use that chisel tip, and I'm just gonna color this in very much like I would with any dye-based marker. So there's nothing fancy here. The one thing I love about alcohol-based markers, especially the Stampin' Blends, is it's going to leave you flawless coverage. There is an alcohol in this marker so that when you go over an area and repeat it, it's not gonna leave those dye-based lines of where you stopped and started. One thing I absolutely love. Now you're gonna need to be patient, give that a couple seconds for that alcohol base to evaporate. And then the magic comes in when you go to the dark shade. And this is obviously for shading. Now sometimes the stamps have little lines in them to give you an idea of where the indications of hues would go. And you can certainly use those. And I'm gonna add a little color here at the top, and I'm gonna stretch this across the bottom. Just add a little shading here. I'm gonna come up in that little bit of line, and I'll add a little bit there. Just like before, you're gonna need to be patient for a couple seconds and let that alcohol base evaporate. And in my case, because this is large enough, I'm gonna come back to the lighter shade and I'm gonna pull these two colors together. So there'll be a blending here versus a real differentiation between the light and the dark. I want you to keep in mind too, that this is not really important when you have little tiny areas like that in the fruitcake, okay? This is really for areas that are larger. Now it doesn't look like much just now because again, that alcohol base is evaporating. But when it's all done, you're gonna have beautiful highlights of light and dark, which makes it look like you fussed for hours, and it's gonna make you look really professional. Okay, so I did then use my scissors. I know, I'm gonna pull these off. They might make a little bit of a noise. How many of you remember your scissors, right? We have gotten so spoiled with dies, haven't we? The Sweets and Treats stamp set does not have dies, but don't panic because we all learned how to cut when we were in elementary school, and I promise you these were not difficult. So let me show you what I did ahead of time. I have my fruitcake here, and I also have my pie, and I had a little tiny linen thread bow here. This is all part of your project sheet with your instructions. And the reason I added this ahead of time was because I wanted to use liquid glue. I want to point this out to you. This is a great tip. Do you see how narrow this is? Really tiny for a glue dot. So what I decided to do instead of a glue dot was to use liquid glue. Now this is another great tip for you. If you like the Tombow multi-purpose liquid glue, which of course most of us do because it's very, very strong and it dries quickly. I love this little dispenser because it's going to keep the glue face down, which means it's ready to use. But whenever I have those little tiny spots like this, I find this tip very challenging because it's not narrow enough. So let me show you what I did. I actually squirted this glue into a precision tip glue applicator bottle. You're going to be able to find this and the little black stand. They're both part of my craft room favorites over on my website under shop and then scroll. There's tons of things there that I use that are fantastic. This little precision tip is worth its weight in gold. And the only reason I did this ahead of time was so that you didn't have to sit while I watched it dry. Okay. Little tiny, tiny drop. And then when it's all done, this little silicone cap goes right on top of here, and this has never dried out. Now, if you're wondering what the rubber band is for, is if you're doing quite a bit of gluing, that obviously can flop. So thank you to a YouTube viewer who gave me this suggestion, which made my life so much easier. So when you're all done, just go ahead and cap that. And I recommend that you store it straight up inside your drawer or on top of your work surface. Okay, let's move over to the fun part. I want to give you another tip tonight. This was something that I thought of when I went ahead and I created this card. Because of the size of my pieces, I did want a greeting here. And again, remember that the crease is going to be on the right-hand side. Just to make it easier, let's go ahead and let's open this up and let's lay it flat. I wanted a greeting, but I didn't want it too big. And this one is a little bit large. This one says, a tasty treat for someone sweet. And I was like, well, I was kind of worried that was going to impede on all the pieces I was going to put together. And where you put the pieces are important, so make sure you stick with me. I wanted for someone sweet. All right, here we go. Let's push these off to the side. I'm going to turn this face up. Now, you can take a dye-based marker. Careful what I said, dye-based. You are never going to use an alcohol-based marker on your stamps. That will ruin them. Ask me how I know. I will never teach you something I haven't already tried. You're going to take out a piece of household tape. This is a trick that I have done for years. Create a little tiny tab on one side. And what you're going to do is you're literally going to mask off what you don't want to use. This is so slick and so easy. But watch. So I want a tasty treat for someone sweet. I want for someone sweet. So we're going to cover up a tasty treat. Now, when your words are very, very close, I want you to look to make sure that your scotch tape or your household tape is not going to cover part of a letter that you're going to need. I'm coming in with my Memento Black ink pad. Watch. You're going to ink it up. Super important. You got to take off the tape. Now I'm reaching down for the garbage can and I'm looking. And because it's photopolymer, I'm in great shape. I can see exactly what's been inked and what hasn't been inked. There we go, for someone sweet. Love that because it allows you to omit areas on your stamp that you don't need. Now remember, as I mentioned to you, oh, look what I did, I stamped it backwards. Did you guys see that? All right, here is the good news. I made one ahead of time because I was afraid I would make that mistake while I was chatting. All right, crease on the right, everyone, crease on the right. And then beforehand, I stamped what's gonna be on the inside. This is Bring On Christmas. These all come from the same stamp set. All right, let's move on to the next step. Red cardstock is going to create a base here. I do recommend this layer. I find that it creates it a little bit sturdier for the mechanism for this buckle. Let's go ahead and bring in the silicone craft sheet. And here on the back side, we are going to add our adhesive. Now this time, I want you to be generous. I want to make sure that you border the entire card because it's going to have to slide in and out. All right. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to border this on the red piece. Again, with your crease on the right. See, I'm telling you after I made that mistake. Trust me, I make plenty of mistakes. You should see my trash can. And there we go. We've got our card. Now, the next step would be to adhere this, but I have to also give you a tip on where to put the images. So you'll recall this was the card base. Let's go ahead and let's add adhesive now to the back side of this panel. And the exact same thing, I want you to be generous around the perimeter of this cardstock. Because again, that front half is going to create the buckle and it's going to actually be pulled on from time to time. All right, this now, see, we're going to open it up. It's going to go straight in the center. So you're just going to visually look here on the sides and then the top and the bottom to see if it's about even. Now this designer series paper is quite helpful because you're going to notice the rows of the little peppermints. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to attach that here and I'm going to press that in place. The next thing I'm going to do is I am going to take my fruitcake. And I've got that here. Now whether you decide to add it with liquid glue or dimensionals is entirely up to you. I'm going to go with dimensionals tonight. But I want to give you a tip on why I didn't stamp it on here and color it. Because alcohol-based markers will bleed through your cardstock. That is normal. Very, very normal. So a couple things that you can do is if you want to skip the step and leave some of these stamped on here, you're going to want to make sure that you layer this with a piece of designer series paper or coordinated cardstock so that it'll hide that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and use some dimensionals. So I'm going to use some of my larger size dimensionals here. These are the full size ones. And I'm going to add them very balanced to this card. Most of my cards get mailed, so I'm very cognizant that they are going through the mail meter at the post office. Now these are the mini dimensionals, and those are a little bit smaller, which keeps me from having to cut up the big ones. Just saves time, and I absolutely love these. And then I'm going to use my paper piercing tool attachment here on my Take Your Pick tool. That's going to help me remove those paper backings. It sure makes it a lot easier for me. This now is going to go in what appears to be the visual center of this card. I'm looking to make sure that I don't cover up those words. Now, for the next piece, let's go ahead and let's do the pie now, and that's gonna be on this side. Now, I wanna caution you about something. Do you see how this is already raised? So that means this side of my pie is going to need adhesive, while this side of the pie is going to need a dimensional. Otherwise, there's going to be an elevation difference. So let's go ahead and bring in that silicone craft sheet one more time. Let's add a little adhesive here, so that'll be tacked down. Let's take off that paper backing to that one. And this now is going to get overlapped here. How high or how low you put it is entirely up to you. Now, here comes the important part. This gets opened. This gets closed. This is the buckle. This just gets tweaked into here. Now you're going to add your other piece. If you were to add this piece beforehand, intuitively, you're going to want to go all the way over here to help balance out that white area. But keep in mind that part of that is going to go underneath the buckle. So what I did is I chose to use a full-size dimensional. Let me just go ahead and grab one of those here. And I'm going to take off that paper backing. Now I'm going to give you one more tip while we're together. You see this little narrow area right here? You're probably thinking, Lisa, if you don't add something there, it's going to flop. Yes and no. It typically doesn't bother me, but for those of you that it does, I want to share a really great tip with you. I'm going to take the edge of my dimensionals, and I'm grabbing my sticky scissors. I keep a pair here in the studio with ribbon on them, so I know I can gump them all up. Don't want to use my good ones, that's for sure. The outs of the dimensionals always have a thick border, but this is a great little way for you to chop up those little extras. Watch, and you can cut them a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to take off that backing. If you like fussy things, this is great for you. And then I'm going to use my take your pick tool, I think, to help me get that on there. And then I'm going to center that here. Now, I may have made this just a hair too long or too short or too wide. Let's take a look. No, I think it's going to be okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to center this while it's in the buckle. So there's going to be some overlapping here. And then we are just going to press that in place. Okay, my goodness gracious, does it get any easier than this? Isn't this cute? All right, so let me show you once again. This is going to come out, and then this is going to open. But you'll recall that I mentioned to you that I have six other cards to share with you. Three of those are Fun Fold, and they all use the exact same stamp set, Sweets and Treats, and I coupled them with the Closia dies because I want to show you how amazing these dies are. Are you ready? Okay, let me pull out my cards. And bear with me, I've got a little bit of a raspy throat. I've been fighting allergies here in Florida while it's still incredibly warm. Now, these six cards I'm going to share with you next are all part of my monthly online card making class. I would love to have you join me. The class starts today. There's a 4-day ordering period only from today through Saturday, which is October 16th. Look at this Fun Fold. Ready? Ooh, gotta love that. Isn't that fun? All of my card class customers will get a video tutorial to make all six cards. So this is one of them. In addition to the tutorial, ready? They're also going to get a step-by-step PDF tutorial. So they get a video and they get a PDF tutorial. For those that like to read, I've got you covered. Multiple pictures of every card, step-by-step cutting dimensions, pictures, supplies, good news. And look at this one. I'm going to give you tons of tips in the video. So it's just like this, but obviously all six cards. I'm going to teach you all kinds of techniques. And ready? Watch. This is going to come off, and then this opens up. Oh, isn't that fun? This little slide mechanism is wonderful. So that's the three Fun Folds. Now, if you're wondering how you're going to join me for this month's card making class, it's easy. You are going to use the exclusive card making class host code between now and Saturday only. There's only a 4-day ordering period. You're going to need to place an order of $50 in product or more using that code in order to get the free video and the free PDF tutorial. So this is the fourth card. Okay, here we go. We're going to keep going. I'm going to save my favorite for last. Here is our fifth card. Super duper cute. Look at those cloche dies, how they come into play. But I want to point out something for you tonight. This sixth card, are you ready? Not holiday whatsoever. Either is this one. Did you notice? This is a birthday card. So don't think that this stamp set only makes holiday cards. It certainly doesn't. Are you ready? Here's my favorite. And you're probably thinking, how did you do that? Well, quite easy, and the video is going to walk you through the whole thing. It's going to teach you step by step to make this card, and obviously this could be used for any theme, any occasion, of course, and you could change the colors and the emblems to make it masculine as well. Now, I would love to have you join me for this month's card making class. So remember, it has to be a $50 product order before shipping and tax using that exclusive card making class host code between today and Saturday, which is October 16th. You'll get the video and the PDF tutorial, and all my card class customers get an exclusive invitation to a private live stream event right here on YouTube. It's called Live with Lisa. This private event includes multiple demonstrations, product prize patrol, and multiple of 8 extra tutorials, all as a thank you for their order. I would love to have you join us this month. I know that Gina has shared the link here in the live thread, and we'll make sure that it's here down in the link below so that you can navigate that when you pick up your project sheet. Head over to lisastampstudio.com, and if you're brand new there and you scroll down about halfway, you're going to get a pop-up. It's going to invite you to my newsletter, and I would love to have you sign up, because if you love tutorials, guess what? You get a free tutorial in that newsletter every Thursday that is not shared on my other platforms. It's exclusive to that. I would love to have you join us. It's a no-frills thing. And if you haven't already, hit the like button tonight, that little thumbs up icon next to the title. That helps me immensely here on YouTube. And do me a favor, subscribe if you haven't, and hit the bell icon and the word all. That's going to send you notifications, and you're going to want those reminders, because I'm coming back live with you on Monday for a fun fold card. Oh, it's got a twist to it, and I'm not going to give it away. I hope that you're going to join me. I will be live right here on Monday, which is October 18th at 8 o'clock Eastern Time, and I hope that you'll be here with me. Gina, thanks so much for moderating tonight, and I hope that you will be joining us for this month's card making class. Bye, everyone.